On the 23rd of December 1920, the British government brought into law the Government of Ireland Act, which provided the legislative basis for partition. On the 3rd of May 1921, partition was forced on the Nationalist and Republican people of the North, trapping them in a state to which they gave no allegiance to. This denial of self-determination brought in its wake sectarian programmes, the establishment of the armed wing of unionism, the specials, the Special Powers Act, and the creation of a sectarian and repressive state. Attacks by the state on the nationalists and Catholic communities who rejected partition deepened. Over an 18-month period, 280 nationalists and Catholics were murdered in Belfast, murdered by the armed wing of unionism as they obliged their paymasters in government in carrying out their orders to coerce, murder and structurally terrorise as set out about consolidating one party rule and a president parliament for a president people. Of the 280 victims of the state's murder gangs, 160 were murdered in North Belfast, 146 of these within a less mile radius of the Greater New Lodge area. The pogrom was fundamental to the foundation of Northern Ireland as a sectarian state where the minority was to be terrorised into submission. In response, the Belfast IRA campaign intensified. The Northern IRA waged a war of independence against the Unionist government of the newly established Northern Ireland and in defence of the Nationalist people. 100 years on from the partition of Ireland, this Easter we remember another generation of arisen people. A people who, like their comrades 100 years ago, followed in the footsteps of McCracken, O'Donovan Rossett and Clark. People like Winifred Kearney, Tom Williams, Jimmy Steele and Maura Drum. An unbroken connection of resistance. Resistance that witnessed a people rise up in the face of adversity. These men and women, volunteers Ogden Aaron, Cumna Ban, Fianna Éireann and Sinn Féin, gave their lives in defence of a people and the cause of Irish freedom.
Poblach na hÉireann, the provisional government of the Irish Republic to the people of Ireland, Irish men and Irish women, in the name of God and of the dead generations from which she receives her old tradition of nationhood, Ireland, through us, summons her children to her flag and strikes for her freedom. Having organised and trained her manhood through her secret revolutionary organisation, the Irish Republican Brotherhood, and through her open military organisations, the Irish Volunteers and the Irish Citizen Army.
Having patiently perfected her discipline, having most shortly waited for the right moment to reveal itself, she now seizes that moment, and supported by our exiled children in America, and by gallant allies in Europe, but relying on the first on her own strength, she strikes in full confidence of victory.
We declare the right of the people of Ireland to the ownership of Ireland and to the unfettered control of the Irish destinies.
To be sovereign and indefeasible, the long usurpation of that right by a foreign people and government has not extinguished the right, nor can it ever be extinguished except by the destruction of the Irish people. In every generation, the Irish people have asserted the right to national freedom and sovereignty. Six times during the past 100 years, they have asserted it in arms, standing on that fundamental right and again asserting it in arms in the face of the world.
We hereby proclaim the Irish Republic as a sovereign independent state, and we pledge our lives to the lives of our comrades in arms, the cause of its freedom and its welfare, to the exaltation among the nations.
The Irish Republic is entitled to and hereby claims the allegiance of every Irishman and Irishwoman. The Republic guarantees religious and civil liberty, equal rights and equal opportunities to all citizens, and declares its resolve to pursue happiness and prosperity of the whole nation and all its parts.
Cherishing all the children of the nation equally, and oblivious of the differences carefully fostered by an alien government which have divided a minority from the majority in the past, until our arms have brought the opportune moment for the establishment of a permanent national government representative of the whole people of Ireland and elected by the suffrages of all our men and women.
The Provisional Government, hereby constituted, will administer the civil and military affairs of the Republic in trust for the people. We place the cause of the Irish Republic under the protection of the Most High God, whose blessing we invoke upon our arms, and we pray that no one who serves that cause will dishonour it by cowardice, inhumanity or rapine.
In this supreme hour, the Irish nation must, by its fallow discipline and by the readiness of its children to sacrifice themselves for the common good, prove itself worthy of the august destiny to which it is called.
Signed on behalf of the Provisional Government, Thomas J. Clark, Sean McDermott, P.H. Pierce, James Connolly, Thomas McDonough, Eamon Kent, Joseph Plunkett.
O'Glock Danny O'Hagan. Danny was shot dead by the British Army on the 31st of July 1970. O'Glock Michael Keane. Michael died while on active service on the 4th of September 1970. 1971. O'Glock Billy Reid. Billy died while on active service on the 15th of May 1971. 1972. O'Glock Jared Crossan. Jared died while on active service on the 9th of March 1972. O'Glock Louis Villian. Louis was shot dead by the British Army on the 14th of July 1972. 1973. O'Glock Francis Leggett. Francis died while on active service on the 18th of January 1973. O'Glock Jim Sloan. Jim was shot dead by the British Army on the 3rd of February 1973. O'Glock Jim McCann. Jim was shot dead by the British Army on the 3rd of February 1973. O'Glock Tony T.C. Campbell. Tony was shot dead by the British Army on the 4th of February 1973. 1974. O'Glock Brian Fox. Brian died while on active service in England on the 21st of December 1974. 1975. O'Glock John Bach Kelly. John died while on active service on the 21st of January 1975. Fian Robert Swab Alsop. Robert died after an accidental shooting during an arms lecture on the 23rd of March 1975. O'Glock Seamus McCusker. Seamus was shot dead by members of the Workers' Party on the 31st of October 1975. 1976. O'Glock Rosemary Blakely. Come in the van. Rosemary died while on active service on the 13th of January 1976. O'Glock Martin Bugsy McDonough. Martin died along with O'Glock Rosemary Blakely while on active service on the 13th of January 1976. Fian James Pavlo O'Neill. James died while on active service on the 12th of February 1976. Colin O'Grady Sinn Fein. Colin was shot dead at his home by Loyalist gunmen on the 5th of June 1976. 1977. O'Glock Michael Patrick Neill. Michael was shot dead by undercover British soldiers on the 24th of October 1977. 1984. O'Glock Sean Maxey McIlvenna. Sean died while on active service in Blackwaterstown, North Armagh on the 17th of December 1984. 1988. O'Glock Dan McCann. Dan was shot dead by undercover British Army soldiers while on active service in Gibraltar on the 6th of March 1988. Thank you.
let an old woman a-plucking young nettles. I seen there saw me coming hang the sun the while to the song she was humming. Glory, oh, glory, oh, to the bold Fenian band. Some died by the glen side, some died by the stranger unwise man hath told us that their cause was a failure, but they loved dear old Ireland, and they never feared danger. Glory, oh, glory, oh, to the bold Fenian band. I went on my way, God be praised that I met her, be my life long or short. Sure, I'll never forget her, a queen bee, a brave man, but we'll never have better. Glory, go, glory, oh, to the bold Fenian band. Glory, go, glory, oh, to the bold Fenian.